discussion of working, of dialogue, because I had visited much more recent universities before I went to Cambridge. And for a while, it was a surprise and a discovery for me. And this is what I wish to say that, because I think that we are here together for intellectual, academic discussion, but this should never be completely apart from a personal and kind, a very vital dialogue. Well, Professor Pinsker, last session, the first full session of this symposium. Thank you very much for coming, for being here with us, Professor Pinsker, and you can
address this.
Thank you.
In the introductory to Logic of Philosophicus, Wittgenstein tells us that the theory of knowledge is philosophy of psychology. And Kennedy's theory is the reference, if you want it, is Kennedy's Logic of Philosophicus 4.1.1.2.1. In the previous paragraph, in the same number, he has spoken of psychology as a natural science. Psychology, he says, is not more akin to philosophy than any other natural science. The remark on the theory of knowledge which immediately follows is the second paragraph of this same number. So when he speaks of philosophy of psychology, he means the natural science of psychology. A believes that P is the case, and A is thinking P, as examples of, I quote, certain forms of proposition for psychology, which if psychology is here, supposed to be a natural science, would be rather like calling X fell from a tree, and that certainly did not mean those which belonged to the natural science of psychology. An invention of the natural science of psychology, for example, like the way in which computerologists talk about bytes. Licenses for those forms of proposition, for example, Galileo believes that the earth moves is the case, are ones belonging to a human report at their time. This is so, even though my Galileo sentence is rather stilted. I made it rather stilted in order to make it a substitution to sort of anybody. This very much characterized the philosophies. And these two facts rather characterized the philosophies of Philosophical Investigation 2.14. We may suppose from his letter to Russell about 30 years earlier that then, as a young man, he had a more hopeful view of the natural science of psychology. Then later on, when he said, and methods of proof. However, it is not important to the great importance of the Tractatus thought that theory of knowledge is philosophy of psychology. The importance is to the history of philosophy, in the sense the history of philosophic thought. And here I'm not thinking of.
Thank you very much. The discussion of Wittgenstein's views on names has started from the Tractatus. We are told that he follows Frege and Russell in treating a sentence or proposition, science, as a function of the expression it contains, that is 3.318. An elementary proposition is formed out of names, and is thus the certain function of any name or names it contains. and they must be represented by the schemata. F, X, phi, X, Y, phi, day, X, Y, etc. Here, this is 4.24. Here, at the outset, there is a threat of certain confusions, which I'm sure have not always been avoided. First, the grammar of function of is very different from that of father of, let us say. A man who is father of somebody is a father, so some men are fathers. But if some number or quantity is a certain function of another number or quantity, that does not mean that a number or quantity may be a function. That is mere nonsense. This nonsense has, however, long flourished, triggered it much to curb its growth, comparing in particular his essay, Wasistan Funktion. It was Wittgenstein himself who put me on to reading the essay, Wasistan Funktion, shortly before his death. He knew exactly where it was to be found in the Cambridge University Library. Contrary to a view I find this to spread around, Wittgenstein, at the very end of his life, maintained a keen interest in Frege and regarded Frege with deep understanding and respect. Now, nobody ought now to think that a function is a sort of number or quantity, namely, a variable one. As I believe Russell said, the worse your logic, the easier it is to prove things by it. Just as a function from numbers or quantities to numbers or quantities is not itself a number or quantity, so a function from names to sentences is not itself a name or a sentence or any sort of actual expression. It is rather a pattern on which sentences are formed. There is no reason to impute any pervasive confusions. One, due to carelessness about quotation marks, about the distinction between sign and thing signified. Frege was, of course, scrupulous about this. The other, a vagueness as to whether a proposition or function is a function, or rather, is an actual expression. Here referring specifically to the term propositional function. These strictures do not apply to the former apparatus of Principia. A good symbolism has a life of its own, not damaged by false explanations. This is a gross misunderstanding of the way these symbols are actually used in the formal arguments of Principia. On the contrary, any proposition of the form of phi A B is necessarily also of the form F A.
It is a good thing. Conceptuais podem que por isso realmente comparar com os que se acaba muita coisa, se acaba muita coisa da gramática. Muita filosofia se acaba muita coisa da gramática.
Versus Maimonides, in the Guide to the Perplexed, says that it is a superstition to think that it is good for fruit trees to have manure spread around their base. He was wrong. It is not superstition, it is perfectly correct. That is a good thing. He thought it was superstition. Now, Wittgenstein, die Sprache, oder das Denken, ist etwas Einzigartiges. First quotation marks. Das erweist sich als ein Aberglaube. then in brackets, Yishyashchum is an exclamation mark. Herefore the Ruthen selbst durch grammatische Täuschungen. Surely, if I might ask him, they're not in connection with this paragraph. What do you mean by superstition? And he said, I should think very much the same as you do. When people call something superstition, it's just a way of abusing, or pouring abuse on something, and they certainly mean, but it's an error, it's all false. And I suppose, I don't know what Moses Maimonides meant. I assume that the translation, I don't know Hebrew, I assume that the translation superstition is correct, but let us suppose that it is correct, and it would appear that he was calling what was simply a mistake about horticulture. But at any rate, he surely meant that it was wrong. It was a mistake. Here Wittgenstein says, Aber, nicht Irrtum. This is what has interested me very much, and in connection with your topic. Well, magic and superstition,
that is the same problem as you about Wittgenstein's view on the real world superstition. From the point of view that it is a typical superstition in the way
of art. Could it be so that superstition has to do with hypothesism?
You see, he says that the superstition is hervorgerufen durch grammatische Täuschungen.
Yes.
And, well, I'm finished. Well, I'm just here
because of the irrational kind of approach. When you see the market, the right answer.
Chris, remind me, because then I want to make a short comment.
Distinguishing magic from science is that magic does not have a direction of evolution in itself.
Lots of people now believe in what they call pyramid power. You make a little pyramid out of some material, and then, for example, if you put your razor blade under the pyramid, it stays sharp longer. New methods of magic develop. There are other examples. For example, men did not always play cards, but once they began,
it is evolution.
Yes.